Hi everyone, welcome to another episode of Thirsty Thursday. It is bargain beer review time, but before we get going, as you know, we always try and explain some of life mysteries to you. What happened to the lost city of Atlantis, besides getting lost of course, and how come wedding licences don't expire? Anyway, up today on the taste test, we have an English Pale Ale, which is a Marston's EPA. Our friends Marston's are probably the biggest brewers in the UK. Now, this cost me £1.09 English pence from supermarket chain Morrison's. You can see the artwork on that. It's quite sort of floral, decorative, quite funky, quite clean and crisp. And the top, it's quite a few of the Marston's at the moment because they are the sponsors of our cricket team. Little cricket crown on there. Right, it is, well, it's 3.6 on the ABV. English Pale Ale. Let's get this cracked open. Just for a change, got one of these like keyring bottle open, so I'll give that a whiz just to see what it's like. Ooh. Not much can of smoke on that, to be honest. Got a nice clean tall glass. Let's get this bad boy poured. You can see already from the pour, it's a nice golden, call like a golden ale colour. Drop the pouring off there. Let's whip that up to the camera. Look at that, it's a beautiful golden strawy colour, that, isn't it? Exactly what you would associate with a pale ale. Now, it's just the weather for this sort of beer at the moment in the UK. Temperature's going up a little bit, so that's not too carbonated, not too gassy. Probably about two-thirds of a, well, going down, probably half a finger, but going down. But let's get this... let's get this sniffed and tasted. You get a nice zesty on there, citrus, maybe a little bit of orange flavour in there as well. There's something in the background as well. It might be a very, very faint toffee note, but very, very faint, and maybe a little bit of bready note in there as well. From the appearance and the initial smell, they do, or one of their sister badges, which is Jennings, do one called Cock-a-Hoop, and it's quite similar to that, I think, but it's going for a taste test. Ladies and gentlemen, as always, very good health to you all. Very clean, fresh. You get the citrus in the mouth feel as well. Very refreshing. It's one of those drinks that if you know people who drink a lot of lager but don't necessarily want to get into ales, this is maybe one of those that's in between for them, that would be a good stepping stone for them to go from lager drinking into ale drinking. It's very clean, very fresh. I don't know if any of you watching on the home brewing side of things have maybe done like a Canadian blonde type beer. It reminds me a little bit of that. Hop wise, there's definitely Cascade in there, and I'd imagine it's some Styrian in there as well, Styrian Golden Strand. But that is pretty good. Ideal weather for it as well. The lacing isn't overly zealous, which is probably what you might expect on a beer of this type. You see that beautiful clear on that. Actually, really nice. Body-wise, so it sits somewhere between a lager and an ale, as you would imagine, being called an English pale ale. So that's probably, you know, a medium mouthfeel on that. But yeah, if you see one of those, pick it up, give it a go. As I say, that was £1.09 English pence. I am going to finish this off now and recommend this to you all if you see one. Pick one up, lovely in the hot weather, I would give that a very, very solid 8 out of 10. Right. Oh, blimey. Pardon me. And if my mum's watching, sorry. Thanks for watching, guys. And as always, see you again for another episode of Thirsty Thursday. Be seeing you.